Hello friends, welcome to our channel. Today we will discuss about the auxiliary memory. In this section we are discussing what is the concept of the auxiliary memory in computer organization, in computer system or computer architecture subject. So as we can see that is the most important thing, what is the scenario behind the auxiliary memory generation and the concept, and how it is useful, and why we are using this concept and day by day increasing the more attraction by the people. So we will discuss today about the auxiliary memory. So friends, if you have not subscribed the channel, subscribe the channel for more videos. So these are the example of the auxiliary memory. You can see that in daily life we are using the auxiliary memory, for example pen drive, floppy disks, DVD, hard disk, CD-ROM, all the magnetic tapes. So these kind of the example of the auxiliary memory. There is the pictorial representation of the architecture of the auxiliary, means how it is associated in the system and how the functions are governed in the computer architecture or computer organization subject. So friend, we will see here in the system there are the two types of the input methods. First one is the through the input device we can data by the taking the through the keyboard or mouse, and the secondly we can take the input from the auxiliary storage. Suppose we want to see a movie from the DVD or CD-ROM, so we have to just insert a hard CD-ROM or DVD inside the CD-ROM. So by using this scenario we will be able to see the picture or movie. So when it goes to the data to the processor process the data and finally display the movie. So that is the output device. By using this we have to see and display the movie. So by using the auxiliary memory, so that is the this kind of the linking. Auxiliary memory go to the data processed by processor and then produce the display or output. Secondly, if we are taking the input from the input devices and it go to directly fetch the data from the memory and processed it and display to the user. So that is the working scenario in the computer architecture, how the auxiliary memory are functioning. Now we will understand what is the concept of the auxiliary memory. Auxiliary memory is also known as the secondary memory. Here we can reside the data permanently, means by using the auxiliary we can not lose the data whenever the power failure. So that is the scenario of the auxiliary memory, that stored the data permanently. So these are the types of the auxiliary memory. For example, magnetic disk is circular plates just like the CD-ROM, DVD-ROM, constructed of metal or plastic coated with magnetized materials. By using this kind of the scenario, if we will go into detail, so that will have the cylindrical and tracking. By using the reading the track through the lens or laser beams, we have to read out the data and finally it display to the user on the display screen. Now the second types of the magnetic, in the olden days we have to just listen the song through the cassettes through the plastic tapes like the that will insert inside the audio system and we have to listen the song. So that is the kind of the scenario, magnetic tapes, by that store the data into the magnetic tapes. That is the also form of that we have already discussed, how the function the auxiliary memory are associated with the main memory, CPU and cache memory. So that is the input out through the input output process we have to take the data and then finally processed and finally go to the display the user. So in this video we have to learn what is the concept of the auxiliary memory and how we will discuss and how what are the architecture and what is the functionality of the provided by the auxiliary memory. So friends, if you have not subscribed the channel, subscribe the channel for more video. Thank you.